The topic for today's guide is creating a vibrant gradient orb. It's a simple process that uses just the gradient mesh and warp tools in Illustrator, but the result is pretty cool. Being vector-based means these orb graphics are extremely versatile, so they can be used for all kinds of branding projects or just for creating fun artwork. So open up Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. The size doesn't matter too much, but ensure you're working in the RGB color mode so you have a nice wide variety of vibrant colors to choose from. Select the ellipse tool and draw a circle on the artboard. Hold the shift key while dragging to keep the proportions in check. Select and clear the default black stroke, then activate the fill color. Double click the color square and choose a new hue. This can be any color whatsoever. The fun part of this tutorial is repeating the steps with new color selections each time. Select the gradient mesh tool and click anywhere within the circle. Color pick a new hue using either the fill box, the color picker, or the color sliders. Add another gradient mesh point elsewhere on the circle and choose a third color. Your color choices could be complementary to the other colors or totally contrasting. Illustrator will automatically blend between them. Every time you add a new mesh point, it creates a kind of net of other points. You can alter these by selecting with the direct selection tool and changing the fill color. To select the points around the edge, use the lasso tool to draw a selection around them. Then you can choose a new fill using the color picker. Continue adding colors around your circle until you're happy with the result. Now to really mix them up, select the twirl tool. Double click on its icon to edit its settings and change the intensity to 10%. Hover over the center of your orb and then hold the Alt and Shift keys while dragging to increase the size. Make it roughly the same size as your circle. Reset your mouse position in the center, then make several small adjustments one click at a time. It's difficult to see the effect while it's been applied, so move the mouse away and then use the Command and Z undo shortcut to step back and remove any glitchy bits until the twirling looks nice and smooth. You can step forward again with the Command Shift and Z shortcut if you went back too far. Drag your circle over to one side, then drag a copy back while holding the Alt key. Circular orbs look cool, but you can also turn your graphic into an abstract shape. Switch to the Warp tool from the Twirl Tools menu group. Double click the tool to edit its settings and bring the intensity back up to 50%. Click and drag around to bend and warp it out of shape. Don't go too mad though, otherwise the glitchy bits will start to appear again. The fun thing about this effect is you can achieve a different result each time. Draw another circle and use a totally different fill color. Add the gradient mesh points, each with a different hue. The more mesh points you end up adding, the smaller each new color spot will be. Once it's all swirled together, the more colors you have, the more detailed the effect will be. Mixing both dark and light colors really helps with the contrast too, especially if you vary between complementary colors. What you do with these gradient orbs is entirely up to you. They could form the basis of a vibrant brand identity if paired with type, or they could just be used as cool pieces of artwork. So I hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial for Adobe Illustrator. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up to help spread the word. Subscribe to the Spoon Graphics YouTube channel to stick around for more of my content, and pop over to my Spoon Graphics website to grab yourself my free design resources bundle. As always, thank you very much for watching. See you in the next one.